introduce the next speaker. Let me introduce the next speaker, Olga Khatuntseva. She will speak about the generalized analytical solution of the problem of determining the universal profile of the turbulent flow on incompressible fluid. Please.
Thank you. The study and description of the turbulent regime of fluid flow is extremely interesting but difficult task. There are still discussions where the turbulent regime is in effect stochastic and whether the randomness in this process is apparent based only on the limitation of our knowledge. On the other hand, the question whether the deterministic Navier-Stokes equations can describe this regime has not been solved. Apparently, there is no reason to doubt the stochastic nature of turbulence, if only because in the few problems that allow analytical solutions of the Navier-Stokes equations, for example, in Hagen Poiseuille problem, the Coet planar problem, and the Poiseuille planar problem, this solution describes only deterministic laminar flow regimes. The rather successful applications of the Navier-Stokes equations in solving practical hydrodynamic problems in the implementation of turbulent flow regimes can be explained by the fact that they lose their deterministic properties when integrated by computational method and thus are able to simulate random process. In order to describe both laminar and turbulent flow regimes based on the same equations, it is necessary to take into account what distinguishes them from each other. For example, entropy production due to excitation of stochastic disturbances. Entropy is a functional of phi, probability density of the realization of the velocity disturbances. In this report, it was proposed to consider the Navier-Stokes equations in a phase space expanded by the introduction of an additional stochastic variable. As a result, an additional term appears in the expression for the total time derivative, characterized by the production of entropy due to the excitation of stochastic perturbations. For laminar flow regime, entropy production takes zero value. The additional term disappears, and the transition to the Navier-Stokes equations in the standard form is carried out, the solutions of which describe only laminar flow regime. This slide shows how the functional derivative of entropy is determined by the probability density of realization of a random variable of velocity. Entropy production can be characterized as the inverse of the time interval at which entropy changed by one. In this case, the total time derivative in the expanded phase space with an additional stochastic variable takes the form. The inclusion in this expression for the total time derivative of an additional term characterized by entropy production, which is always non-negative, allows in particular to take into account the irreversibility of physical process in time in a case where this production is non-zero. The Navier-Stokes equations for an incompressible non-heat conducting fluid in an expanded phase space with an additional stochastic variable and boundary conditions can be represented as the solution describes the value of the viscosity of the velocity at the certain moment in the time, at a point in space, at a given value of the probability density of the realization of the velocity disturbance. For a large Reynolds number, two solutions are analytically found in the Huygens-Poiseuille problem, the Planar-Poiseuille problem, and the Planar-Couette problem. One of which corresponds to the laminar flow regime, the second to the turbulent one. On this slide, using the example of the Huygens-Poiseuille problem, you can see how the solution is being searched by the method of separating variables. If parameter A takes a zero value, then the solution of the equation is reduced to solution corresponding to the laminar flow regime. If A is not equal to zero, then we get a solution corresponding to the turbulent flow regime. However, for a non-zero value of parameter A, it is not possible to find a smooth solution satisfied to given boundary conditions. In particular, the Bessel function of the first kind of zero order does not satisfy the condition of sticking of the liquid on the Piper wall. We can try to find the asymptotes of the solution of the equation satisfying the boundary conditions in the wall region and in the center of the Piper. The absence of one smooth solution and the existence of a region located between two asymptotes of the solution or a region in the vicinity of the point of non-smooth intersection of the asymptotes will indicate the possibility of the emergence and self-maintenance of stochastic process. The solution of the problem in the wall area will be determined by the value of parameter A. And the value of this parameter itself will be found from the combination of two boundary conditions. The condition of fluid adhesion on the pipe wall and the condition of equality to the unit of the ratio of the product of dynamic velocity and dynamic distance to the dynamic viscosity at the outer boundary of the viscous layer. As a result, we obtain an expression for the asymptote within the boundary of the viscous layer, which we extrapolate beyond this region. The condition of convexity of the velocity profile in the center of the pipe leads to the expression. This expression up to the Karman constant coincides with the experimental view of the velocity profile for turbulent flow in the wall region. However, just as the experimentally found velocity profile cannot be extrapolated to the entire pipe region, so the asymptote of the solution found for the wall region is not a smooth solution in the entire flow region. It does not satisfy the symmetry condition of the flow in the pipe, the condition that derivative of the velocity in the center of the pipe is equal to zero. We can take such asymptote in the center H constant. In order to describe the velocity profile in the entire flow region, it is proposed to introduce the concept of generalized velocity. The generalized velocity consists of two terms. each of which is the product of two multipliers. One of the multipliers is a function characterizing the asymptote of the solution in the wall and in the center region. As that second multiplier functions f and g is a function characterizing the degree of influence of this asymptote on the generalized solution. This slide presents experimental data for a universal dimensionless velocity profile near a smooth wall and logarithmic function extrapolating them. A large discrepancy in this data can be seen, with increasing distance from the wall. Here is a comparison, is of experimental data and the generalized velocity function. The profile has features universal for different values of the Reynolds number, describes experimental data quite well in a wide range of distance from the wall. The difference in the Y plus range from 10 to 100 may be due to the phenomenon of intermittency in the transition region. This slide shows analytical solutions to the problem describing the turbulent velocity profile, dimensioned by the velocity on the pipe axis for the laminar flow regime corresponding to this Reynolds number. It can be seen that in order of magnitude, this corresponds to the experimental data shown on the next slide. Similarly, a generalized solution for the velocity of the turbulent flow regime in the planar puzzle problem is obtained. Also, the presented method solves the problem for the planar quad flow. The velocity asymptotes for the turbulent regime of fluid flow on this problem have the same functional dependence in the wall and central regions of the canal. However, the parameters included in these dependencies are different for these areas and are defined by the following expressions. Here is an expression for the generalized velocity of turbulent flow in the planar quad problem. The values of the parameter for the central and wall regions of the canal at different values of the Reynolds number, as well as a comparison of the velocity profiles found by the presented analytical method experimental data. You can see a welcome response for experimental and theoretical data. For other Reynolds numbers. On the slide, you can see the main conclusions from the report. Briefly, the presented method, based on taking into account the difference in entropy production in laminar and turbulent flow modes, allow us to find solutions to hydrodynamics problem based on the same equations, namely Zanavier-Stokes equation written in space expanded by an additional stochastic variable. And this method gives good correspondence of experimental and theoretical data. Here the publications of topic of my report. Unfortunately, of them are presented only in Russian. I hope in the future to publish the continuation of my research also in English. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. Other question?
I would have one question, if possible.
Okay.
Thank you. It was interesting to listen. My question is related to the stochastic variable. Would anything change? I mean, there are, I think, multiple possibilities of types of stochastic variable, stochastic process to include here. Would anything change if something would change in this stochastic part in terms of the properties of the...
Okay, thank you for your question. The stochastic variable included as a part of the entropy is a functional of probability density of the realization of the velocity disturbance. You can see on this slide, phi is a probability density of this velocity disturbance. And when we written the equations which this additional part, we have task which in a space with additional stochastic part of task.
Okay. Thanks. I think I understand. Thanks.
Okay, thank. Any question? Okay, then let's thank again speaker for the very interesting talk.
Thank you.